Hallelujah. And as soon as she turned the curve over here, she started explaining why she's in that situation. You don't know what I've done. I've done nothing. I belong in the situation. No. I've been taken from under the blood.
And all she's explaining, I said,
all I know is God is here. Amen. And I'll be the last one to take something off a person that God put on them. So you know what I did? I said, hey, did you repent from that? She explained her situation. I said, did you repent from that? She said, yes. I said, okay, just to make sure, lift your hands to God. Why don't you repent to God? Tell God you're sorry for that. And church, she just started to worship him. She just started to give God praise. And she was up there all feeble, standing with a cane. And then she entered into a place. Hallelujah. And the cane dropped. And her hands went up. Brother Edison grabbed the cane and took it in his office.
Church people can be so quick.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your child acting up, when they come to you and say, I can't let my kids be without your child. Your child unstable. Keep those kind of comments to yourself.
Yeah. Yeah.
You don't have to kill that parent's spirit because they're trying to do all they can do to raise their child.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
We come, we feel so high minded, we just want to kill people. And anyway, hallelujah. You look, this girl, she's saying, Daddy, Daddy. And then Brother Brown says, he says, hey, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to test her faith.
Yes.
Amen. I'm going to bump into her.
Yes.
Now that's real justification.
Yes. Amen.
Justification is, hallelujah, God putting himself in your way.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. You don't deserve it. But on your journey, I was in the world, you was in the world, all was in the world. On our journey, some kind of way, we bumped into Jesus.
Wow.
He put himself in our way. None of us were looking for him. He saw us and he said, there they go. And we were forever changed. He put himself in our way. He said, I want to test our faith. Why did he do that? Because he knew he had to give. That could help her.
Yes.
And he said, honey, are you lost? She said, yes, sir. He said, so you look for my dad.
Yes.
And she said, well, he said, why are you here? We come to see that divine healer.
Right.
He said, oh, you don't need that. She said, with all my heart.
Yes, amen. Amen.
He said, when she started to talk like that, he felt something climbing all over him.
Yes.
Oh my, he felt the gift being activated.
Yes.
And all she was saying was, I believe.
Yes.
It's not your faith, it's his faith. You're not the one that's being put on the you can keep the other hand on me. And she had the prophet all jacked up. She had his jacket locked up. And he grabbed her hand. He said, "Them cataracts still living in your eyes." He says, "Honey, bow your head." And he stopped praying. He said, "Don't lift your head until I tell you." And he started praying for her. Hallelujah. And then he said, "Honey," after he finished praying, he said, "Open your eyes." And when she, church, when she opened her eyes, you know the first thing she was looking at? She was looking into the prophet's eyes.
Amen. Yes. Praise God. Hallelujah.
And then she started to see lights and all these things. I said at the Sailor's Church, when we read this message, we're looking through the eyes of our prophet. Yes. Everybody else started to pay attention because they realized that girl was once blind.
Yes.
And then they started running over there, and Brother Brown slipped out, he was gone.
Amen.
Church, you're still the same God.
Yeah.
Still the same.
Come on, musicians, I'm closing. Come on, I'm closing. Hallelujah. He's still the same God.
Amen.
All we have to do is believe.
Amen.
If you have a situation tonight, I'm here to say that the Holy Ghost is present.
Amen.
We don't have to walk out the same way we came in.
Amen.
You know, even like John Ryan, he came in the prayer line and he didn't get it right then, but he kept confessing.
Yes.
He kept saying, "Thank the Lord for healing me day after day. Yeah. Thank the Lord for healing me." Yeah. And then one day his eyes came open.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. He's still the same God.
Yeah.
He's still the same.
Hallelujah.
He cannot change.
Amen.
You know, the Bible says, wherever two or three are gathered, in my name, there am I in the midst.
Amen.
And whatsoever they ask, and they believe them. Now, are we fulfilling that scripture? Wherever two or three. Now, do I have two or three believers in here?
Yeah.
Pay attention real close. I got two or three believers?
Yeah.
Now, I want you to check that part of the scripture off. We got that part. Come on, participate with me. Check it off. Check it off. We got that part. Two or three believers. Amen. I'll gather in my name.
Amen.
Whose name we come in tonight?
Jesus.
Okay, let's check it off.
Amen.
We got that part of the scripture fulfilled. He said, "Wherever two or three are gathered in my name, I will also be in the midst." Now that we got the two or three, we gather his name, so that means the rest of the scripture has to be true.
Thank you.
are gathered in the name of
Jesus.
There will I also be in the midst. And whatsoever they touch and agree,
amen.
Hallelujah, I will do it.
Amen.
You have to ask for it. You know the problem? That's too simple. It's too simple. We want to see the pillar of fire. Have you been paying attention? You're looking at the pillar of fire. Jesus was born, they never saw the pillar of fire again until after he left.
Amen.
Because why? The pillar of fire had became a man. Woo! You didn't see the pillar of fire again until Acts 9.
Amen.
That's when you met Peter, huh? That's when you met Paul. Hallelujah! And the light knocked him off his horse.
Oh,
of God has swept over the congregation. And some of you have been delivered, but you don't know yet that you're delivered. And so I want everybody to testify. And I want you to testify in the form of a song. Let's stand up. Just slip your hands up. And let the Spirit of God do the rest. If there's anything that's still trying to hang on to you after we finish praying, may it leave you.
Amen.
He touched me. You're telling God, and you're testifying that He touched you.
Amen.
Do you believe that?
Amen.
Amen. He touched me. Oh.
Like the man that was blind, Brother Branham told him, 1 year, you're right.
fool of yourself saying you're healed. He said, but I know I'm healed. And the moment he said it, bam, his eyes opened up. One that does the healing.
Yeah.
And he wants to do it now, he does it now. If he doesn't want to do it now, tomorrow he'll do it, the next day he'll do it. He'll do when he knows you got to the place to receive what he has for you. But you believe it now.
Yeah.
And go believing. And you're going to walk right out of your condition. Amen. Praise the Lord. I'm going to say the closing prayer now, Brother Mike. Because, you know, let us have prayer. Our gracious God and Heavenly Father, what a wonderful manifestation of a Son of God, Christ, the mystery of God being revealed in a bright form through this wonderful gift that you have given. Father, we have feel the effects of his testimony. And may the saturation of the Holy Spirit flood every heart, every soul, every mind. Amen. And as we go from this place, Father, may we go to our homes rejoicing, believing, amen, trusting, and coming again tomorrow in the presence of Almighty God and the presence of the angels of God that are with us here today. Lord God, as we go along our way to singing the songs of Zion, talking minister, and Father, you'll continue to anoint him for tomorrow's service. Send down the Holy Ghost, Father. Send down the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise God. We thank you, praise you, and we go out now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen and amen. Please be seated. The ushers will see you out. Refreshments outside, so don't leave here without it. Get some of it, send them back. Just to titillate their tonsils. There's coffee, is there tea or something? Oh, they're back, they're prepared. So God bless you, deacon brothers, when you see them out now. Amen.
Touch.